The F-35's Block 4 upgrades and Tech Refresh 3 means more technology in the fifth generation fighter. And with more technology, there's more heat that can cause problems with the plane's electronics. That's an issue that companies, including Honeywell, are working on. Defense News Weekly stopped by the company's show floor at the Air and Space Forces Association's Air, Space, and Cyber Conference to see what it is offering as the Air Force makes its upgrades.
As the F-35 advances, it's getting more electronics and an engine upgrade. What is Honeywell offering for the F-35 as it makes those upgrades to help with the avionics?
Yeah, so our power and thermal management system has been a part of the program since the very beginning. So we've had over 675,000 flight hours of the PTMS operating. So we know a lot about how it operates in the entire airframe. What we're looking at doing is increasing the cooling capacity from 32 kilowatts currently. We can go all the way up to 62 or 80 kilowatts of cooling capability for Block 4 and beyond on the F-35. So we're really looking forward to working with Pratt & Whitney on the ECU upgrade and how we can take the best advantage of that to provide the lowest cost and lowest risk cooling capability for the F-35 going forward.
And Pratt & Whitney, the ones being the manufacturers of the F-135 engine that's currently in there, right? What kind of problems would we be seeing if they couldn't control the thermal, they couldn't control the temperature in the planes?
Well, the really important thing for the F-35 going forward is the Block 4 capabilities that are going to be introduced in the 2030 timeframe. Having the cooling capability support a new radar, new electronic warfare, new processing systems is going to be really key to enable the aircraft to operate with all that additional capability. So what we're looking in that timeframe, putting in just some upgrades to the existing PTMS that would be better heat sinks, better fluid management of the cold liquid loop of the PAO fluids to enable greater cooling up to that need. What we're looking at beyond that is getting into some more of the additive manufacturing capabilities with microtubes and changing out heat exchangers that would, again, in the very compact footprint that the PTMS has in the F-35, provide that double to triple cooling capabilities.
And in terms of additive manufacturing, that's always something big here at the AFA show. How will it play a role in the process with you? Does that have to be really finite printing? Does that have to be really refined printing? Or is it more of a normal run-of-the-mill?
Yeah, so it will absolutely be a higher technology capability of actually designing things that you could not produce without additive manufacturing. So creating the microtubes, you would not be able to do that in castings and forgings and any of the current heat exchanger core production activities that we do. It's getting to a finer level of detail in the actual printing. So it's some of our most advanced manufacturing technologies that we're currently doing in Phoenix. That is supporting commercial engines and commercial aircraft. So we do have the technology, we do have the capability, but using it for that additional cooling capacity is something that we're working with Lockheed Martin to be able to incorporate to, again, advance the cooling capabilities without having to do a whole tear apart of the F-35. And again, take advantage of whatever the F-135 ECU upgrade is going to make available to us.
Does the F-135 engine provide all the energy you need to produce the cooling within the aircraft, or do you have to produce your own power as well?
Yeah, so we actually have as much bleed air as we need off the F-135 engine as it is. So with the greater capabilities of the ECU, that makes even more bleed air available. And so that's something that we're working with and wanting to work more with Pratt & Whitney on how best to take advantage of the bleed air. We have opportunities to actually reduce the amount of bleed air that we're using today by turning on a combustion mode in the APU section of the PTMS, which again, further capability, improved reliability, and greater cooling capability, not to mention that the PTMS also generates all the electrical power for the entire aircraft. And so having that ability to generate the electrical power and the connectivity with the other systems is really key to ensuring the F-35 Block 4 capabilities are supported, as well as with the engine upgrades and what capability that brings us. Keeping the cost low, keeping the technology risk low with technologies that we've already proven in other aircraft and on the F-35.
Matt, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.